Here are axial images from a CT pulmonary angiogram of a patient who came in with acute breathlessness and chest pain. In this case, we can see that the pulmonary arterial enhancement is overall satisfactory for evaluating the pulmonary arteries to the segmental and subsegmental level. As we scroll through systematically, I'll focus our attention to the left side. This is the basal trunk, which then branches into its segmental and subsegmental branches, supplying the anterior medial, the posterior and lateral basal segments. We notice that there are low density filling defects within the vessel, extending into its segmental and subsegmental branches on multiple contiguous slices. The findings are compatible with acute pulmonary embolism. This case illustrates the signs and examples of both occlusive and partially occlusive pulmonary emboli. There is occlusive pulmonary embolism within this segmental branch to the posterior basal segment of the left lower lobe. Notice how the entire branch is not enhanced and the artery is enlarged compared to the adjacent vessels. A partially occlusive thrombus can often be seen peripherally against the vessel wall, forming a sharp angle with the arterial wall. This is another example of a partially occlusive pulmonary embolism where the thrombus is seen peripherally against the vessel wall. A partially occlusive thrombus can also be seen surrounded by contrast material in its long axis, forming the railway track sign. Here we have another example of the railway track sign. If there is a partially occlusive thrombus seen in a vessel in cross-section, this can form the polo mint sign. This is another case where the polo mint sign is seen very nicely. With large pulmonary emboli, the patient may be at risk for circulatory collapse secondary to right heart failure. The early detection of acute right ventricular strain or failure allows appropriate management. Although right ventricular strain or failure is best assessed on an echocardiogram, there are some features that can be seen on a CTPA. Firstly, the presence of right ventricular dilatation can be diagnosed if the short axis of the right ventricle is wider than that of the left ventricle. We obtain the short axis measurement of the right and left ventricle. And this is not present in this case. Other findings of right ventricular strain or failure include flattening or deviation of the interventricular septum towards the left ventricle, or contrast material reflux into the hepatic veins. The next step is to change the window to lung windows and assess for associated pulmonary findings. In many cases, the lungs may be normal, or simply mild atelectasis in the area supplied can be seen. Pleural effusions are also possible. Pulmonary infarct is not common, as the lungs are supplied by both the pulmonary arteries and the bronchial arteries with rich anastomosis. However, in cases of insufficient collateral circulation, pulmonary infarct can occur. Pulmonary infarction typically appears as a region of consolidation or ground glass attenuation that is wedge-shaped or rounded. Look in the region of the lungs supplied by the involved vessels. They can be a mixture of consolidation and ground glass attenuation, and some contain air lucencies inside.